45 percent, nothing could be added in the SSG concern, because except that parties could not produce all the things they have produced. Bombay Tribunal upheld the SSG contention, they dismissed the departmental appeal and they allowed the SSG. So this is the judgment where it will find that the entire edition was dismissed, deleted, though it is said to be bogus by the lower court's concern. Now the of course that matter is pending the High Court before Bombay High Court, till another term for hearing this concern. Now the what are the obligation of the assisting officer to duty of DO, what SSC should do. Now here the where issue the show cause before disallowing assisting officer should issue the SSC notice calling that all right, these are the parties stated like this. I want to disallow this expenditure, what you have to say. That is what before disallowing, we should call for the under 143, not simply cannot disallow without giving an opportunity to ask his question. Now what SSC should do in such circumstances, that is what 219-7-21 duties of the respective. Now what SSC can do? He can ask the officer, issue some of the supplier, give an appointed cross-examination, inspect the books of account, verify his profit, examine his banker, cross-check with his assessing officer, cross-check with the STO, cross-check with the government agencies, and by discharging, by this way, we can put it in writing, this also please provide us. Then I think possibly once again burden shift back to the assessing officer. He cannot simply rely on the statement given in state tax authority, then he can disallow the over expenditure is concerned. Now this is the judgment of the Delhi. It is very important for this reason, you know, that the it's reported in the 23 DTR and 183. The person is here also, the entire expenditure disallowed. Matter went to the High Court, payment was made by account paycheck, and ultimately the court took the stand that no disallowance can be made, and because SSC will produce the bank account of the other party who has where it has been encashed, you know, we can able to get details, so they said no question disallowance at all. Now the Supreme Court said that tin box that we are referring to make your bail, an SSC made without being an SSC opportunity setting of its case for lack to be set aside. So if you are not given reasonable opportunity, possibly of course now said will no bother set aside, when the matter goes to the tribunal, possibly it may get once again sent back to the EOS concern. Now the Supreme Court 26th IDR, that also 775, the if the assessing officer desired to use any material against the SSC, then he should give an opportunity to the SSC concern. Otherwise, he cannot use the anything against you. And similarly, 210 IDR, the 103, Calcutta High Court says that SSC entered cross examining the who has examined by the sale tax authority from the income tax they want to do it, then they have to once again give the cross examination opportunity to the you. Then here is the AMD communication that the SSC department is dismissed. Then if the AO wants to use the some statement made before him, then on request of SSC bound to put the department for cross examination. If he not given this opportunity, the according to be that entire SSC may be set aside, or the tribunal or the higher officers may ask him to give an opportunity for cross examination. The party doesn't turn up, possibly your pattern will discharge, and beyond your that statement, there cannot be a addition concern. Of course, well-known judgment is the Kishan and Chalara, which all of you must know, that anything that the opportunity person must be given, any information or the one department want to use against you, then you can put the judgment, and then they are bound to give the information to you. Now the many times question is put because in the VAT authority, now today we find that when you go under their website, they must take your full names. That they can be the sole ground for rejecting your purchase is concerned. The answer is no, that is what the 107-TTA-395, that they are given that merely on this information sent to the department. Addition cannot be made under 69, for opportunity must be given to the SSC to come from the seller. Then the second issue is that the affidavit. Sometimes what we find that the department may say, all right, that party must have filed affidavit. But merely filing the affidavit, unless they give an opportunity for cross examination, that is not valid. Suppose they file affidavit of the department, or they file affidavit before the state tax authority, the officer wants to use against you, you can ask them, all right, give me the copy, give me an opportunity for cross examination. If that person does not turn up, then the validity of the affidavit is lost. Same thing also applicable for the SSC also. Supplier report after your SSC must have that supplier must have given some wrong statement. He must have given the affidavit, now new affidavit. Getting it all right, I have given the actual change to you. And if you file the affidavit, then in that case, that the burden is for you to produce that party for examination before issuing officer. If it is not satisfied with that affidavit, he can once again examine that party, and if he gives the correct statement, then no addition can be made. Passing mark, I will let you make to that the only 144-190-195 Mumbai Tribunal, that given drafting affidavit also very, very important. Yes, Mr. Shah, because he must have read the judgment, because he said one of the members said that it is one of the matter, the affidavit not properly drafted. So because they are not properly drafted, he has not condoned the delay, and then ultimately he gave the very lengthy order, what should be contained in the affidavit, how should be drafted. So those who are drafting the affidavit, please see that, read the judgment, possibly you will get some idea how the affidavit should be drafted, how it presented before the authorities are concerned. Now there are, these are the some of the case laws, where you will find that the 104 DDA 809 and the 1-1 line only, ratio, because if you have to explain each case will take about 45 minutes. D.G. Diamond is saying that one sales of the SSC accepted purchase cannot be doubted. Very reasonable. Then the 258 IDR 654, only profit embodied of sale proceed can be taxed. Third, through 216 and 610, suppressed sale cannot be the income, only net profit can be taxed. Then the Supreme Court, Sanjeev Ula, it says that it is settled principle of law, tax law, that the real income which you tax under the Act. Suppose the entire purchase and resale of, even very, maybe your GP people sometimes did it, and you know what real income should be taxed. Then the 285 IDR 435, stamp dealer's case wherein consumption should fully prove. If you are able to show the consumption, there no addition can be made. Then this Madhukar Biga, only 5% of the total disallowance restricted to disputed purchase. Dishendra S. Motani, this is very important judgment, where you know that the, of course he not reported, unreported, where the assessing officer disallowed entire purchases, matter went up to the state appeal. State appeal took the stand that, all right, I will disallow 3% of the entire GP. So there may be, let us say, 100 crore purchases, 100, out of that, this may be about only 10 crore. He said, for entire, I will disallow GP, that's how we have put 3%. Man went to tribunal, tribunal to the standard, no, you cannot disallow the entire purchaser GP. At the most, you can do only 10 purchases. That means, suppose, if I have 10 crore, is your any bogus purchaser, on that 3% only disallowable. Not the entire. This is what the Jitendra Motwani, that is the case. And the interesting, let me also refer here, because the judgment, what they considered the Delhi High Court judgment, that is the 250 IPR 575. Why am I referring to 250 IPR? Normally, department always like the judgment, 250 IPR 575 is again necessary. And the 23 DTR 385, which we referred earlier, that is ILO, after that of the Delhi High Court, afterwards. In that 23 DTR prepared report, they considered the alleged element of 250-575. The High Court itself stated that in that 250 IPR, there is evidence to show that money has come back to the SSC. So therefore, that whenever the argue for the tribunal, the department may quote the 250 IPR, then you should ready the answer, all right, 250 is, but that is not the facts of my case, that I am distinguished in the 23 DTR and also the Mumbai Tribunal is concerned. Now the next one is that if the wage judgment is made, assuming that all right, you reject your books of account, then can he apply for 43 The answer is no, that is what the Narendra Kumar on 42 ITD 2303 they said they were disbanded and went to the surrender of what I agree is concerned. Now you may also have to refer to a later judgment, you know, that the cash payment is concerned, that is reported in the cash payment exceeding fiscal limit, that is on that beyond particular limit. If it is raised by the cross check and account pay check. Now what the court has analyzed is there is a difference between the old provision and new provision. The new provision has come from the 13-7-2007 that refers only account pay check, not the effort by the cross check or that is the reason they say that because of new provision, if cash payment is made, though it is by cross check or cross bank draft till disallowance matter for the year 3. You are very careful after advancing 13-7-2006 is concerned, before that it will be covered under the old provision is concerned. Now the other judgment that also are characterizing, there also that the addition was made entire purchase on 69, matter went up to tribunal say that only cheap addition of 3.2% should be made. Then the 69C, the C 284 IDR, there also 59C cannot apply to the purchaser concerned. Then the 54 SOT purchase recorded in the books account, though did not carry the address of the parties, but cannot be treated as unless recorded in the books, party address not there. Then said no. Then entries were made in the regular books of account, provision of 69C is cannot be applicable. So that will cover some of the issues. What we say that in initially as you mentioned that the where are the issues may come in the course of the your discussion or in course of assessment. Similarly, solar traders, trader, quantity details, no disallowance. Manufacturer, because I have analyzed like trader, this is judgment. If you are dealing with the trader, you may quote 92 ITD. If you are dealing with the manufacturer, you can quote 252 ITR, that is the digital purchases burning. Then the manufacturer 76 TDA, there is stock register maintained, then the excise register maintained, no question. Then trader and manufacturer, if it both are there, then the 49 ITD 177, they say that the trader and manufacturer mode, not account venture, no allegation amount received back. That is again notice for the amount sales were accepted. Then the gem and jewelry, some questions, I think somebody asked me on that, the part, affidavit was filed, sales bill were shown, valuation report was produced, they said no question of making addition. Similarly, income surrendered from having been added. Suppose, assuming that the, if you agree for the addition, can it be 8IB or 8IB 10, if we allowable or not, tell you what my reference earlier, if there is a consequential effect, you may be able to get it. In the when you assuming that the you have agreed for the additional are concerned, that is what 229 acres is 42 which I made earlier. Now based on this, now we have to see that the whether website of the asset department can be information for you only. That is first question you have to answer. That the answer is merely on the basis of website information, your assessment cannot be reopened. Unless the officer makes little homework and try to find out what evidence he has given that party against your SSC, and then if you are able to show that all thereafterwards he follows the due process of the law, then only you can reopen, not merely by seeing website that so and so also has given the bogus help. That will not be the only ground for reopening your assessment is concerned. Now the issue comes that, all right, assuming he has reopened, can you challenge by your brief? Now most of the cases now the under it is concerned, they are against us. What is 357 ITR 357? What the Supreme Court laid down that the you are having alternative remedies there, therefore you cannot rush the court. You have to exhaust the alternate remedy, then only you can rush the court is concerned. Then the very recently, that is what the in the Kalanti Maran, the judgment not yet reported, that is finding the online ORG. There you know the Madras High Court, considered in detail. They said that after Supreme Court judgment, we will not entertain any petition at all in the High Court against the 148 East concern. That is what the latest view has regarding the 148 East concern. But let me also deal with you that when 148 notice comes, many times we find that SSA does not follow the due process of the law. What he has to do is, that is what the law laid down by the GKM right now, that is the 259-19. When the notice comes, you are supposed to file the return. Thereafter, you ask for the recorded reasons. After recording reasons, you raise an objection in writing. Then officer has to dispose of your objections. And thereafter, if you are not satisfied with the disposal, you may challenge by the writ if you find it you are a good case. Otherwise, you are followed to the process of the law. But many times what you find that you are not following this process at all. Then once again, Bombay High Court, the Asian Paints explained this, that is 296-96. Then the Alana Court 287-91 and very recently 287-337, that is also explained that how SSC should follow. Possibly if you read all the three judgments, when a 148 notice comes, you are able to guide the SSC, these are the things you must follow, then only proceed further, that will help you in the appeals concern. Then the very, very important judgment 48-56, that is on Bombay High Court, what is it? Suppose you do all this till officer not give you the recorded reason. Then if you use the after assessment is concerned, the judicial High Court says that if you give the recorded reason after the assessment concern, that is not valid. So that may help you when going appeal to the challenge in the appropriate forum. Now if the assessment is beyond 4 years, whether still we can run to the court or no. In fact, we find that the very recently appeal CT1-220 Delhi, they have taken a stand that the notice issued after 4 years on basis of DID investigation for any bogus affidavit can be shown. For I have given only those connected with the bogus, otherwise I have not given so many other cases. The Delhi High Court says that the without applying his own mind, you are not justified in voting 147. Recently, Bombay High Court, Nikunj Exam Enterprises, that also bogus purchases, beyond 4 years, the High Court said that no, that you cannot entertain you in the writ petition, only beyond 4 years. Oh, they have, in fact, they said the writ petition has to be not valid, then that they said that the officer is free to do, that is what the bogus is concerned. That's why Bombay High Court, judicial High Court against you, Delhi is in your favor, we don't know what is the impact on that. In the Supreme Court, both of them have taken to the Supreme Court, both the Bombay High Court and also the Delhi High Court. Now the revision. After pre-assessment, the question comes revision. Suppose that the officer doesn't do the 148, can the revision is possible or no by the Commissioner 263? Now here is the case where you find the Mundra scheme, that is also not reported, Pune Tribunal, allowed judgment running into about 15 pages where the issue came, there was a survey, statement was given, bogus, and transporter stated that they are not supplying the goods at all, and the DDA investigation gave the report to the officer. In the course of assessment proceeding, the SSC contained that my quantity data is there, my all the purchases are genuine, though the transporter stated it bogus, but it is genuine. He also put alternative submission before the AO. Alright, if you are not getting the entire purchases as my judgment, you make an additional GP only. Officer, on the basis of that, he made an additional GP. Thereafter, what commissioner revised under 263, stating that you could not have done, you could have once again seen the proper the record of the DDA investigation, therefore, that we took under 263. Matter went to the tribunal. What tribunal does not have, just read only two lines only. He said in our opinion, SSC cannot be said to be silent spectator, that is what SSC comes. But he understood the limitation which he could deal with the survey report of the DDI with the permission of legal framework and according to accepted doctrine of the SSC and come to CAT may not agree with the view of SSC comes, that will not give jurisdiction to him divided into city. But here the tribunal followed the well-known judgment like the 243 IPR, 295 IPR, 328 IPR, 203 IPR, and of course after that the 321 IPR also came. But the two views are possible. Officer taken one view, and that came the no question revision is concerned. What revision is concerned, this is judgment on the bogus purchaser concerned, is bogus purchaser, and the now we come to the grounds of appeal. Of course, the issue comes that whether we should file appeal or not. One has to be very cautious. Suppose the engine is only when negligible amount. So to go in appeal. Sometimes there may be, when you go in appeal, say the appeal may enhance. So you have to take the risk whether go in appeal or not. Assuming sometimes you may have any argument, then go in appeal. Then you should go in appeal. And then the, as I mentioned earlier, you must not only detail statement of fact, grounds of appeal and alternative ground, what you want to take that, all right, my entire purchases allow me a deduction. Alternatively, allow me the GP. Thirdly, if at all P, then you work out on that. Then afterwards, you should take all the ground in the grounds of appeal and also statement of fact. Possibly, you should take that if you have violated natural justice, take that down first. Reassessment, take it. So that way, when the matter comes to the tribunal, at least somewhere, if you are able to catch that, how state appeal or the AO not dealt with properly, that could be the ground for you to set aside in the matter from the tribunal and come to that when they come to settlement commission. I will explain to you that how will help you to the well going once again to settlement commission. Now when this comes, they have to put the penalties. Now the penalties concern, suppose it is not due. In that case, assuming the survey made a disclosure, whatever may be the, then literally not due, there are three judgments on this, that's why you may be intention to conceal, but as literally not due, the literally you are disclosed, there is no question of penalty. There are three judgments on this. Similarly, literally do not file, in survey takes place, not search survey. Then also, some of builders, we say that, though you have intention, literally you are shown, there is no question of the penalty. Now, the surrender of income. Now, you know that many times, we have been told that the officer may say, all right, so you surrender, then we will not levy the penalty. Possibly after Supreme Court judgment that 358 IPR 593, surrender is not going to help you at all, then you may be held up with the levying penalty. Though officer must tell you an explanation, but legally not supposed to give you, therefore that the you may be liable to the levy penalty. Then you will also find that the judgment on the Mahavir Virat Industries, there is a detailed judgment of the that Madras High Court dealing with the bogus purchases only, where the SSA subsidy for the tribunal GP edition was made. Now, matter went to the High Court reversed the judgment of the tribunal. They said penalty should be levied. The reason being what they said, all right, you have given opportunity to cross examine the seller, you have not cross examine the seller, you accepted, ultimately GP you accepted, therefore, that the levy of the penalty justified. This is directly on the bogus purchaser concern, that is the Madras High Court is concerned. Of course, then we do have about 4-5 judgment, that is the one in the Rajasthan High Court, another Chhattisgarh High Court, then Delhi High Court, and then of course the Supreme Court is the 322 IPR 158, and then Nalini Piksha Bombay High Court. But these are not all the bogus purchasers. General principle that the just because the estimation of your GP is met or estimation of property is met, no penalty can be. But now the after the Madras High Court, we don't know that how the courts will literally as regard the issues are concerned. Now the let us come to the prosecution. Why referring the penalty is concerned? Once assuming penalty is concerned, you may be liable for the prosecution. For 278E, the presumption as the culprit mental state that the heavy burden of necessity to prove that you have no mental ability mark. That is what the section says, that the burden is for you to prove, under criminal law, though we burden you on the other side to prove, your income tax you have to prove. So, if that is the case, if the penalty is confirmed, if the amount is used, possibly you may face with the prosecution is concerned. Then, what is the alternative for you? One is go for the compounding. Any stage you can go, even after launching also you can go, but then your fees will increase. Or another alternative is that we go for 273 waiver of the penalty. It's not restricted for 1 year. Suppose 4-5 years are there, you go for waiver. on the commissioner base, at least partly. Therefore, let us say that a labor is the, unless he has labor is the penalty of 15 lakh. Go for waiver, assuming if he gives only 10,000. Till under section 279, he cannot launch prosecution to you. That is what section says, that once commissioner waive partly or fully, then no prosecution can be levied. So therefore that it is worth considering that before the commissioner convinces him, all right, is on to assuming that I am ready to pay the reasonable amount of the, you waive it to some extent, then if he gives it, then I think no prosecution can block against the crime. Then I report the 361 idea to, only for limited purpose, the court said that you can go for all the 4-5 years, not necessarily to 1 year only. Suppose your assessment may be pending, 1 year completed, one. All put together you can make application, and one that is pending, I don't think any commissioner will launch the prosecution till it is course of the matter is concerned. That will help you to, at least to, now the, this is the one provision where possibly I think that the settlement commission. Now the, this is one of the very good provision, at least all these, at least bogus purchase are concerned, one should try to go for settlement commission. Reason being that you will get the finality of the order within 18 months. So we will get the final order. Then the, again that no appeal is provided. Order settlement commission is final. Then the, they normally 99% give the penalty, give the reasonable interest also. Then they will give the immunity from prosecution. Then the one important thing is you will get capitalization. That you will not get under normal provision. You will get the capitalization, you can bring that back the money to your books of account, you can cut into that, from there you can make the payment distance. This is one of the biggest advantage you get it for settlement commission. Now you see that the, in the finance bill, this provision was not there. Yesterday, finance bill become that. You will find in the act, the law they made amendment as to the settlement commission is concerned. They say that extended scope further. Earlier the case was only when the estimate pending. Now they extended your policy assessment also. Not only that, the assessment, he also extended to that 264, 263, and if it is member, it is matter compared from the tribunal to the ITO, once again you can approach settlement commission. That we have been told that the good number of matters where the SSC have gone to settlement commission, the settlement commission always accepted certain percentage of the GP. For manufacturer, certain percentage for your trader, certain for your road contractor. That's why there are precedent how they accepted on that. So therefore that by any chance, if you are having 148 issue, but only one precaution which you have to take, this law will become effective only from the 7-10 October only from, it will effective only from the October, not today. So first October onwards only can oppose settlement commission on this. Issues are concerned. Of course that the, I am told that the, unfortunately that you are the guest who are the honored to be not here. In fact, one provision I thought of just sharing with you, a large gathering of professionals, you will find that the one of the finest provision in the entire income tax act. What you say is that member of settlement commission should be man of integrity, and then the outstanding ability, and also special knowledge of experience properly getting the director of business advice. Because settlement commission was set up in 76, but till today, what we find that the, not a single professional either from the law or from the accountancy, they have not appointed anybody. So I thought that if our guest would have been come, I would have been affiliated, but still it is not very far. I think possibly you should try, at least you should request him, all right, take some of the members from the accounting profession, they will be able to judge better. Take somebody from the lawyers, they are able to share the law better. And take one person from the department, you are objecting for that. Then the really that settlement commission will become very effective to British efforts. I think possibly what a felicitation you wanted to give to your MP would have been achieved. But still otherwise, nothing is achieved, possibly you should file it, but in petition on PIL, somebody thought of filing, ultimately you are not pursuing much in the matter. Then the writ petition, as I told you, we should be very slow. And one important thing, you know, which you may bear in mind, suppose it